This is a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I'm standing right now by your bookstore. We hadn't come up with a name with it yet, but I'm standing by your bookstore, and we're here because even though it's already open, we wanted to do a formal dedication of this sacred space, our new bookstore. And the bookstore exists for the same reason our church does, and that is to reach the lost and develop them into fully devoted followers of Jesus Christ. And so the Bible tells us to make disciples, to make mark and mature them, to teach them, and then to keep on teaching them. So our desire and our call, in fact, is to edify the saints. And so this bookstore in part exists to have inspiration and information for the purposes of edifying believers. But not only believers, we're believing that God will not only help believers, but that God will use this spot, this space, this area, to save souls as well. So we're going to be praying that when people enter this bookstore, that they not only see books, but they see Jesus. And that's our prayer. In fact, the bookstore doesn't exist just for our congregation, but your bookstore exists so that we can bless the community as well. So we want to do a formal dedication, and we want to include you in that formal dedication. What I want to do is I want to offer the Lord a prayer of dedication for our new bookstore. And then we're going to cut this ribbon as a sign that it is now open after the dedication. And then I'm going to take just a few seconds to let the cameraman kind of pan the bookstore so you can get a look at what our workers have done. They've been so diligent in what they're doing. And then we'll go back to worship service. Now, would you join me now in a word of prayer? Lord, we're so grateful today for what you keep on doing at Bates Memorial. You've been so kind. So good. Your favor is evident. What isn't evident is why you give us favor. We know we don't deserve it. We've not been perfect, have not done always what you wanted us to do perfectly, but God, in your mysterious providence, you keep on showering your favor down on us. And you're making this a fruitful ministry. People are coming from the north, south, east, and west, coming to Christ and coming to be a part of this ministry. So, God, we want to be good stewards of the souls that you've given us. And so this bookstore is just another creative way for us to offer something that's food for the soul. And so, God, we dedicate now this space to you. It is holy. We set it aside for your work according to your will. Give us wisdom. Know what to put in this bookstore. Grace when we make mistakes. Bless your people in spite of us, God. And I pray, oh God, that this bookstore will be such an effective instrument of ministry that people will not only think about Bates, but will ultimately, as a consequence of the ministry that flows from this bookstore, that they will look up and tilt their hearts toward you. This bookstore belongs to you in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to ask Reverend Carla Anderson, our Director of Christian Education, to join me as we cut the ribbon for the brand new bookstore. The count of three. One, two, three. Amen. Y'all give God some praise. Let me show you around for just a second. I have the cameraman to come in and just kind of pan the place. You'll notice that it has quite a bit of paraphernalia here. It's got really qualitative book. You can see some of the workers here, some of the volunteers as well. But we've got books, they've got paraphernalia, they even got cups with your church's logo on it. So when you're drinking coffee or tea at work and people ask what that cup is about, you can tell them about Jesus. Amen. So don't forget, this is your bookstore. Take time to come out, spend some money in here, help support your bookstore. And the better we make it, the better God will use it. God bless you. Be blessed by the remainder of the worship experience.